the projects we're working on in the lab right now is the problem of action anticipation. So this means to use visual information extracted using computer vision and then using that information to actually predict and anticipate what the people in the scene are going to do. This actually, the whole research came about for purposes of robotics and robots operating around humans. So we decided that it would be a good idea to look at some frameworks like sports where the rules and the objectives are well defined. So we have been working on techniques and algorithms to anticipate the actions of players in team sports.
Ferrari and her team of researchers first turned to volleyball, where they were able to access a large trove of game film that they used to develop an algorithm capable of predicting player movements with 80% accuracy.
One important reason that we start with volleyball is we have access to a public data for volleyball. That's very important. Because for any machine learning system, if we want to train a system to actually learn something, to behave like a human, to be intelligent, we need like a huge amount of data. And secondly, for volleyball, players are split on two sides. That makes it a little bit easier.
Following their success on the volleyball court, the team has trained their sights on an even more ambitious goal, the fast-paced and complex sport of ice hockey.
So our previous work on the volleyball really revealed that the action anticipation can be very useful in sports, and we really want to test for more challenging environments, especially for ice hockey, where sports itself is very dynamic compared to other sports. So if our algorithm can understand the situations from these even challenging scenes, we really expected that it can be used even outside of the sports to the more of a real world challenging situations.
Ultimately, the researchers believe that this sort of predictive machine learning could be used far beyond the field of play. These algorithms could one day lay the groundwork for seamless human-robot interactions, safer autonomous vehicles, and even more immersive video game AI. But the sports world is not a mere guinea pig in this equation. These AI models could also open up new possibilities in the burgeoning field of sports analytics, making quick turn, in-game analysis available to any team with a video camera and a laptop.
The current state of the sports analytics is that they annotate all those data by the experts in every sports. And once those kind of data is collected after every game, many statisticians are gathered to understand this data and whether they can draw out other models to predict which team we're going to win or to analyze which player should they draft. But the limitations of those kind of retrospective way of sports analytics is that they cannot really use those data for decision making during the game.
To further develop their software, Ferrari and her team have begun working with the Cornell men's hockey team, who are providing the researchers with game footage to analyze and an inside the locker room perspective of exactly what teams are looking for to edge out the competition.
Other companies that exist already, they do some things in terms of analyzing the video and clipping it and analyzing past events. They have no sort of prediction model, right? So for us, I think there's huge potential in it in terms of the potentially we call it pre-scouting opponents, because that's what we're trying to do on our own, just with our own brain. And that's something that as coaches would be hugely valuable, right? Because we're always trying to figure out what other teams are doing and how we can best counter that, right? So if a lot of teams at the college, pro, whatever levels would be very interested in any sort of prediction models that we could use.